from all Kumbhamela, from now onwards, all the spiritual work supposed to be done by Acharya Mandaleshwar, Mahamandaleshwar will be done by Paramahamsa Nityananda. Including fixing the time of the Kumbh Mela. So naturally, we will be the first person taking bath. Because Nirvaniya Kada is first. In Nirvaniya Kada, Swami who gives sannyas will be taking bath first. Because after bath, I have to start giving sannyas. So, we will be leading the world's largest religious festival. Because Acharya Mahamandaleshwar, the Swamiji wanted that I should be leading. They also decided that Swami's organization, he has some big ashrams in Haridwar and Ahmedabad, Calcutta, some places and all. The whole organization will come to Nityananda. Nityananda will be heading the whole organization, the created by him. But more work, more responsibility. Now I have to stretch me a little more. I need now more sannyasis. Ready? The moment I said I need more sannyasis, they said, it's okay, you start the class now. Come on. Please understand, it is not about time. It is the way you experience integrity. Explain that, ma, and make her understand.
It is about being in integrity. When I am in integrity, something will happen where automatically I will be on time. You understood? So you'll have to state restoring integrity. Being in the state of integrity is enough.
How much ever I speak about being on time, punctuality, it is impossible to have 307 people observing time for last 2 days, not missing a single session. Is it possible? How many of you have attended these corporate programs, team building programs? Are they able to maintain punctuality even last day? Maybe one person may maintain as a collective program. So understand, it is not about time. It is about the space you carry. If you carry the space of integrity, you will be there. If you are not in integrity in your business, your relationship will be affected. They are all not separate. You think, no, my relationship is separate, my business is separate, my son-father relationship is separate. I will handle this as a separate compartment, this as a separate road, this as a separate space. No. How many of you think that way? It is not separate. If you are not in integrity with your boss in the office, you will be cheating on your wife. Maybe your boss is woman.
Oh, that's bad.
If you are not in integrity with your son, you will not be successful in your office. Understand, this is the space you carry. It is not individual actions. Understand? I am just expecting you to restore your integrity so that space is generated. Because of this mic and speaker problem, class got delayed more than 15 minutes. Even though I am not a reason, I am responsible. So, I restore my integrity. It will not happen again. I will make sure it will not happen again. As a prize, that today I myself will serve lunch for all of you. So I'll make sure the whole space of this hall is in integrity for the class. I request Dubakur Sound Service blessing. No, I need their blessings. I know I have your blessings. I need their blessings. We'll start the session.
Yes.
Everyone is ready?
Yes.
Can you just sit straight? Yes. Please understand. Listen. Please bring yourself to the space of listening. We'll bring ourselves to the space of listening. We learnt four principles to reclaim our divine right: integrity, authenticity, responsibility, and enriching. Now, we will work on each principles separately to make that principle as our cognition, means to make that tattva as a satya in us, to make that as a part of our bio memory, bio energy. Clear? I am first picking up the subject authenticity. In authenticity, we studied, we understood three parts of us. Am I right? What is that? Inner image, outer image, other's image. First thing we need to work is inner image. How many of you have done inner awakening earlier? If you are expecting seven chakra, seven body, forget about it. It's not going to come at all. I've completely revamped the whole syllabus. It is going to be completely new. So, listen as if you are attending first time. You are attending first time. I also made one more thing. I made inner awakening into two parts. From next time onwards, there will be a 10-day program inner awakening separately, which will be given even through video conferencing. I'm opening it. And the 21 day will be second level program. I don't want people to come unless they are prepared, so that in the second level when they come, and they should not go back as an old person. As an old person, they should go only as a new being. Listen. So be very clear, this whole program is new. All 306 of you are, 307 of you are attending first time. Am I right?
Yes.
So you will not have any hangover of the, I am second time, I know it. No. Nobody knows, not only you, even I don't know. We'll start. The inner image, please listen. Inner image. In Sanskrit, we have a word called mamakara. What I feel as me, inner image, mamakara, is the image you carry about you inside you. Please listen. It is not even the image you think you carry at the surface level. Yesterday, whatever you wrote during the authenticity process, how many of you wrote? That is only surface level. That is not true you. I'll introduce you to you now in this session. I am going to make you experience actual mamakara, actual inner image that you have about you, deep within, which may even be hidden from your own conscious cognition. Listen. Yesterday somebody came and read all beautiful rosy poem about themselves, about him. You are this session is for you only. Specially dedicated to you. Listen. Many times we hide our own inner image from ourselves because it is too much of pain. Man needs hopes even to live the life. Sometime you curse yourself for knowing the truth. At least without this knowledge I would have been more happy. For example, if your spouse is cheating on you, after knowing you will feel, if I did not know, at least I would have been happy. I am giving you one example. Like this, sometime you feel truth is too much. Same way, the truth about you is too much many time in your life. Many time of your life, the truth about you is too much for you. So you keep yourself away from your conscious cognition. How many of you cognize what I am saying? How many of you really believe, yes, I think there is part of me, I have kept it in unconsciousness, hidden away from me. Raise your hand. Every one of you have one part deep within which is hidden even from our conscious cognition. That actual inner image you carry about you comes out only when you are in deep conflict, pushed to the extreme confrontation. Listen. You think many times, anything may come, I'll face it. Like yesterday you read, that kind of a inner image you think you are carrying. When actual problem comes, suddenly you will collapse and tumble down. You will not know what to do and you do not know what you speak. And you blurt out all foolish things. And you act very foolishly. How many of you understand what I am saying? Extreme conflict and confrontation, only at that time it comes out. When I was put in the prison illegally, High Court has declared just few days before, my arrest was illegal. It was done completely illegally and they have no right. That time this jailer guy, he was asking me, Swamiji, do you need any sleeping pills or depression medicine? Because they have ready-made the whole set in the jail. I laughed at him. What do you mean? Because he saw me just sitting quietly in one corner for days. Just sitting quietly in a complete calmness, and I did not stretch my leg and sleep. I just sat quietly for days. Because they wanted to, they thought they can psychologically break me, so they have done many, this cunning third degree torture things, like putting heavy light in the cell and heavy sound. 24 hours they will be cutting tiles. Heavy sound, because these are all the methods of psychologically breaking a person. And in the night time they will pour the cold water as if washing the floor. So the cloth they give for me to lie down is only 1.5 feet by 4 feet. I'm 6 feet tall. So naturally leg has to be out. So they thought I'll ask them, give me one pillow, give me one bed, or give me one blanket. So then they can start bargaining with me. I never bothered. I folded the cloth and sat. That's all. I'm not going to lie down. He was shocked for days. Days together. Then when he came and asked, I laughed at him. He was telling me, however big leaders they may be, Swamiji. He said, he is in the field for last, he is the jailer for last 30 years. 30 years he is in this. This is his life. He says, I have put all top fellows of India in jail. And I have handled all top, who is who, tell me. Every fellow, top names, I put them in prison because I was in various prisons, top prisons. I tell you, you are the first person I am seeing who is not depressed. No, it's not for pride. I am not saying for pride. Even one of the big Hindu guru who was arrested on a murder charge started taking depression medicine fourth day. I won't name. One big Hindu guru. Understand, your actual inner image comes out only when you are in a deep conflict or extreme confrontation. At that time, what comes out is you. That time I was telling, that is the time I was sharing, hey, listen, listen. Enlightenment as a utility value. These moments it helps, you see. It is not pride claiming or a bragging title. It has utility value. Only if you have a right inner image,